Hi, I'm Julie from the Exploratorium. On December 14th, there will be a total solar eclipse visible from parts of South America. For over 20 years, the Exploratorium has been broadcasting live images of solar eclipses, and we'd planned on sharing the one this year with you as well. Unfortunately, we've had to cancel that broadcast due to the COVID pandemic, but we look forward to hearing accounts from our friends on the ground in Chile and Argentina. A total solar eclipse is this really amazing moment when the sun, moon, and earth all align in such a way that the moon blocks our view of the sun. It looks like a giant hole appears in the sky, but we're really looking at the part of the moon that's not being lit up by the sun. And you only experience the total eclipse if you're sitting there in the shadow of the moon, which on Earth, it casts a shadow that's less than 100 miles wide. The moon is constantly moving, and it sweeps a path across the Earth that we call the path of totality. And we've really treasured the opportunity to share the experience with those people who are outside of the path at the time of the eclipse. You may remember the Great American Eclipse in 2017, when over 200 million Americans experienced an eclipse either in person or electronically in real time. We may not be bringing you this year's eclipse, but you don't have to wait much longer to experience one yourself. In 2023, there will be an annular solar eclipse. Now, the distance between the moon and Earth fluctuates over time. And it turns out when the moon is a little further away, it doesn't fully block out the sun. It only partially blocks out. You can actually experience this in an exaggerated way by noticing how much of your field of view is blocked when your hand is closer to your face than further away. When the moon is further away and it lines up in between the sun and the Earth, it actually only blocks the center of the sun, leaving a ring around the outside, which is called an annulus. That's how it gets its name, an annular solar eclipse. The one in 2023 will be visible from the southwestern United States, and we're honored to work in collaboration with Navajo astronomers to bring it to you live from Navajo Nation. So you can see how very special a total solar eclipse is, because not only does everything have to line up, the moon has to be close enough to just block out our view of the sun. And the good news is that that will actually happen in April 2024, and it'll be visible from big chunks of North America. We're excited to share that with you from two locations in Mexico and Texas. You know, eclipses, in addition to being beautiful, offer scientists an opportunity to learn more about the sun. One of the things that we can study is the sun's atmosphere, which is also called the solar corona. Now, normally it's really hard to detect against the intensity of the sun, but in that brief moment that it's blocked out in a total solar eclipse, you can actually view the corona with your naked eye. Of course, this year has been eclipsed by another corona. That is the novel coronavirus. Coronaviruses actually get their name from their resemblance to the solar corona when viewed with an electron microscope. They both look like crowns. For me, thinking about coronavirus and this year's eclipse really reinforces how science helps us understand the world around us. Imagine living in a time where we didn't understand eclipses. The sky would get suddenly dark, and think of how terrifying that must have felt. Now we know enough about how objects move in space to anticipate the exact second that the next eclipse will start, and why. Similarly, we're living in a slightly darkened time right now where scientists have spent the better part of this year trying to understand this new virus. And we're starting to see their success. The developments of new vaccines and treatments gives us a brighter hope for the year to come. And once again, science has created a path for us to choose understanding over fear. You know, experiencing an eclipse really gives you a perspective on where we are in the universe. It's a good reminder that we're all just on this tiny dot floating in space. And this year has really reinforced how we are all sharing this Earth together. And it's provided us opportunities to reflect on the deep impact we have on each other, physically and socially. So please take good care, and we look forward to sharing another eclipse with you when the stars and moon and Earth align again in 2023. I'll see you then.